Lily here, and today I'm going to show you how to make slime. So this one is my favourite one I've made, and it was actually the first glittery one I made. And I made like a big batch just because I really wanted a big one. So then I made four smaller different colour slimes, and I'm going to show you how to make that now. Okay. First, you will need a bowl or a pot and a spoon. Then you will need PVA glue. I got this one from Tesco's for £3. And I've got the Almat non-bio gel, the detergent, and it was from Aldi's for £1. So what you do is you pour in the amount of glue that you want. So I'm only going to do a small bit of it. Okay. And then you don't put much detergent in. You only put a little bit in. So like a few drops. And you just stir it in. And you'll begin to see it sticking together a bit more. So hold the bowl and just keep stirring. And once you think that it's like stopped sticking together, pour in a little more. And then keep stirring. And the way you know the slime is finished is when you keep on stirring, the slime will gather up all the glue in the bowl when you stir it, and then that is when you know it's ready. So see, it's starting to gather up some of the glue in the bowl. So you just gotta keep stirring. And when you actually lift it up in the spoon, you can see the slime is coming up from the bowl. But if it does that, you can tell it's still quite sticky. So you pour a little bit more of the gel or the liquid detergent into here. And see, now I've put a little bit too much liquid detergent in. So I just keep stirring it until I know it can't stir anymore. And if it's like this, where it's more liquidy, you put a very slightly bit more glue in. And see, I can't get it off my hands. So what I'm going to do now, I'm just going to pick it up and see if you knead it together. And you can tell if it's ready, if it's quite, not very sticky, but a bit sticky, it's totally fine. But if it is too sticky, just put a very, very tiny bit more detergent in. So I'm just going to dab it on there. And then I'm going to keep kneading, and you'll know when the slime is ready. It should be more of a sticky consistency rather than a doughy consistency. If it's dough, then it's not the right kind of thing. But yeah, so you keep kneading it, and as soon as you can just pull it off your fingers, it's ready. And see, this is what the slime looks like. So you can play with it, and just make sure you don't leave it on your fingers for too long. Always wash the slime off after you got it off your fingers, because liquid detergent isn't meant to be on your hands for long term. So make sure you wash it off after you finish playing with the slime. So see, now it's getting a little more sticky, so I'm going to put a little bit more detergent in. I'm going to keep kneading it. See, that's about the right consistency. See, I can just, if there's any slime on my hands, I can just dab the slime on there and it comes off. Like that. Now I'm going to put it back in the bowl. So you can, in theory, if you wanted to, you can keep it the same colour as this. But if you wanted it a different colour, you could use food colouring, because that works on there. So I've got a box full of food colouring. So I'm probably, I've done blue, green, pink, light blue and purple. So I'm probably gonna do, I'll do, let's see what colours in here. I'll do the very dark blue. So you open it up with the food colouring and make sure to not put your fingers in there. Do not get it on your fingers because it will stain and it's quite hard to get off. So just put your stick in once, your thingy stick, I can't remember what they're called, but so then you just wipe it all off on the slime like that. As soon as the slime starts to stick, take it out. Never ever dip the same stick into it again, otherwise it will contaminate it. So then if you use it, if you use the food colouring for cooking or something else, you will have slime in your food. So just make sure you don't do that. But after that, if you really wanted it coloured, then you can. And bear in mind that you can't make the colour yellow or red, because if you put red food colouring in and it's already very slightly blue, it'll turn to purple. And if you put yellow food colouring in and it's already very slightly blue, it can turn to green. So you can't make red or yellow, but the rest of the colours I'm pretty sure you can make. So this is really fun making this. So then just make sure when you're done playing with it, you get it all off your fingers and put it in a container or a box, or but make sure the lid, or make sure it's all closed up, because it will go dry and you won't be able to play with it. But as long as it's in a box, it's totally fine to keep forever and play with, as long as you keep the lid on. But make sure you do wash your hands after playing with it. So thanks for watching this video. Like, comment and subscribe for more. And I'm aiming to get about 300 subscribers. So please help me with that. And bye!